I'm always going to be a contender. Anybody who's going to take me on is going to be fearful, and that's what I love. I'm going to come back. Don't worry. I'm going to get some wins. I'm coming back. Doesn't matter where.
I want to be a contender in this league. I came in to try and win. I want to go all the way. Whoever I go up against next, it's going to be a challenge.
Mark Riley reached out to me, and at the exact same time, he and I are going to be teaming up.
And oh, yes! Team Hero pulls up the upset!
Riley, I think you and I did very well together today.
I think we did a hell of a job.
I do too. I think we complimented each other very nicely, and I think we were able to help each other out. I think you and I are a good team, and we can take on whoever's next.
And your winner, Mark Riley!
JTE.
How are you feeling about this?
Well, you know, JTE's... Hey, partner!
What's going on? I also wanted to throw down a challenge. I actually want to get in there and get at JTE before you do.
Yeah!
What?
Woo!
You
yeah!
heard it here, guys.
So JTE, it's your decision if you accept.
What is the name of the home planet of the Green Lantern Corps?
Corex.
And your winner! Ladies and gentlemen, she's back! Classy Clark Wolf!
You beat JTE, that's great, but that means that your next match is gonna be against your teammate.
My teammate?
Mr. Mark Riley!
Me? Oh my gosh.
Getting through the JTE part was gonna be the real hard part. This? Whichever one of us wins, take that belt.
Exactly.
Take that belt, son.
This is going to be a great match because we're together on this. We're going to take that belt.
Jeez. Oh, it's that guy.
Oh, what a surprise. Yeah. It's John Rocha interrupting an interview.
You guys enjoy that sweet little, oh, yeah, you know, we're going to help each other. We're going to try to win. Let me tell you something, what happens, all right? When you're coming for this belt, there's no place for room. There's no room for friends, family members, or any people who lose twice to the champ.
You may be holding that belt, but I don't know how well-earned it was. Okay.
Welcome back to the movie Trivia Schmodown. I'm Christian Harloff.
I'm Ken Napsok. Big one, Harloff. Big one.
Listen, thank you. This is a huge match here, Ken, because you've got Mark Yodi Riley, the former champion of the Schmodown, going up one more time to get a shot at the title. But this time he's got to go through his teammate, Classy Clark Wolf, last year's Rookie of the Year.
This is friend versus friend, colleague versus colleague, ally versus ally. The tension is so thick. It is rumbling around the room, and it's not just because I had Chinese food for lunch. This is a important matchup, and it's weighing emotionally on both these competitors.
It absolutely is. And look, before we even get into this thing, look, we're going to show you all the promos. We're going to get into how it all came to be. You're going to see some stuff from Booker T about who he thinks is going to win in a little bit. But this is all about the championship. Clark Wolf had a shot against Dan Merle. Didn't go her way. Mark Riley has not had another shot at the title since he lost it to Dan Merle almost a year ago. This time, in order to get the championship, either one of them, they have to go through the reigning champion. He's here tonight. Let me introduce to you the movie trivia Schmodown champion of the world, the outlaw, John Rocha. Oh, they're just milking it up, when he's not supposed to be competing.
I love a grown man and finger guns, man.
That's right. All right, so he is here. Take that silly mask off your face so I can talk to you for a second. All right, now listen, I got to ask you, because we're not going to spend too much time with you, because we do that every week.
Christian's right. I earned it.
All right, take it easy. All right, listen. So tonight, you've got two competitors here. The winner of this match faces you for that belt.
Yeah.
They are going to face you. Who What's going to happen? Give me your thoughts on Clark Wolf and Mark Riley.
This is ridiculous that I have to face these two. I mean, I've beaten Riley so many times, it just gets old.
Okay.
You can't even call it a rivalry because, like, at one point, so the other team has to win at some point. Call it a rivalry.
All right. So you don't want Riley to win? Obviously.
No. I mean, I'm sick of playing with. Why do I have to play him? Like, is it because he's your friend? He ran Schmodos.com for a while.
Or he's 7-3.
Well, sure. 7-3. How many threes? I'm one of those. I'm two of those three, ain't I?
Listen. He's an ex-champion and he's fighting hard here too. And what about Clark Wolf?
Well, Clark Wolf took a while. Like, remember when Clark Wolf took a hiatus? Do you remember that? Because you couldn't handle the losses. I mean, it's ridiculous. We want a tough champion. That's me. A tough champion.
All right. So, look, I don't want to keep you up here all night.
But
I
will say one thing. Oh, yeah, go ahead. You got a question?
I was going to say, who do you got tonight? You got to pick.
I got Classy Clark Wolf.
You got Wolf?
I do. I believe in the Wolf. You know why? Because I know what it's like to be hungry.
Yeah.
I know what it's like to get knocked down and come back and want something. That's what I did to win this belt. So I'm kind of in the Classy Clark Wolf corner.
All right, so maybe you get your wish, and maybe you'll be facing Classy Clark Wolf. Whoa. All right, so there you go. That's the champion. That is the Outlaw John Rocha with his new championship belt. There you go.
Yeah, I'm going to have this for a long time.
All right, get out of here.
So it doesn't matter who wins.
All right, get out of here. All right.
So wow, Rocha brings passion.
He does.
And I'll tell you, I know what it's like to be hungry. I ate one day, 4 days worth of food in one day one time.
I believe
that. I get it. I get where he's coming from here. But he's got a hard edge. But the people react to that, too. They love him.
It could backfire in his face, though, because as he goes up there screaming and yelling, I think that Wolf and Riley are both listening, and that's just going to drive them a little harder. But we'll see. But let's talk about Wolf and Riley. Here's a little story about how this all came to be.
I beat JTE, feeling good. I want that title shot. Rocha, today is not about you. Yeah, for once in your life, something is not about you. I got something to say to my competitor today. I love you, Mark Riley.
Hey, oh, I love you, Clark Wolf.
Hey. Partners.
Partner, how you doing?
I'm good. And this isn't about being nasty. Sorry, guys.
No, you know what, Schmodown fans? If you're looking for smack talk, this ain't your game. Okay, this is going to be, I don't know what you would call it, this is a practice for the Rocha match, if you will. Team Wolves of Steel, we are united, we are going after that belt for Rocha. If it's me, great. If it's Clark, great. We're going to do it.
Yeah, you're going to get your smack talk and your bloodshed in one more match.
Yeah.
Because believe me, the Wolves of Steel are hungry, and we're going to tear that belt right out of his hands.
I love that. You know he's going to be talking during the whole match that we're in. He's just going to be like sitting there and going, oh, I would have known that.
Oh, I would have known that then. I'm 400 years old. I know everything.
He's the oldest person in this league.
He's the oldest person I know.
He's the oldest person here in Burbank.
Yeah, and that's saying something.
That is saying something.
All right, so Rocha, we're coming for you.
Yeah.
Like, there's more smack talk in this interview than we thought, but not.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, Rocha, you suck. Yeah, that's whatever.
Yeah.
But this is
going to be good.
Yeah, this is good because you know what? We've known each other a long time. We balance each other out. Hey, look at this. We're a team, okay? And the two of us are now playing for a belt. We are on the doorstep for that belt, and we're a team. Huh. I wonder why that is.
I don't know, but I...
Is it because we're really good?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it's because we're really good.
So, everyone who has a belt, look out.
Yeah.
Santa Claus, you too.
Yeah.
Taking your belt. Oh, I sound like Rocha.
You know what? I'm with you. Yeah. Screw you, Santa Claus.
Get out of here, you mean old fat man.
Yeah. You child weirdo.
I'm really good at smack talk. This is why we do this.
It's kind of like when Harry met Sally. We're just like sitting there, remember the cake?
It's just like that.
Yeah.
All right, buddy. Well, right. Here we go. I'm excited. It's going to be awesome.
All right.
Look out.
Well, they're hugging and they're excited to be here, obviously. And you see that to them, it's more about beating Rocha than it is even facing one another.
There's such a mutual respect between Riley and
Wolf. Partners.
They're partners. They're running mates. And this is, like I said, it's taking a toll, but they are both competitors.
Yeah.
And once they get in that fighting pit there, we'll see what happens.
All right, let's go to the tail of the tape. Ken, what do we got?
Absolutely. Starting here with Mark Riley, his strengths are across the board. He's very strong. This guy's been watching movies since like the womb. He's a fan of classics, Star Wars. He knows he's Mark Yodi Riley, and his other strength is not losing hair. with Clark Wolf. She's got, you know, again, well-versed knowledge, but she's an expert in Sandra Bullock movies. That can come into play. Tom Hanks movies, we see that hurt people before. Horror thriller, that's one of her, of course, her specialities. And being the classiest person in a room full of schlubs all the time is a strength as well.
It is a strength. And even though you've given some strength, now we need some keys. Here are some keys to victory from the five-time WCW champion himself, Booker T.
Can you dig it, sucker? What's up, guys? This is Booker T, WWE Hall of Famer, six-time World Heavyweight Champion, and just all-around badass, if you know what I'm saying. This week, y'all, on the Schmodown, we got, again, classy Clark Wolf versus Mark Riley. Now, Riley is a former champion. And let me tell you, he's chomping at the bit to get back in the title picture. We know he's sharp in the first round lately, scoring 14 out of 16. If you have that kind of round in the first round, it could be an uphill battle for classic Clark Wolf. But you can never count her out. You saw what she did against JTE. 2016, Rookie of the Year. Been so close to winning that championship. And with a win, she will be so close again to getting that title shot. You know the way I see it? It's gonna go down to the wire. But I got the former champ, Mark Riley. He's gonna edge this thing out by a hair. That's just the way I feel it, guys. This Booker T, world champ, Hall of Famer, total badass. Check out Reality of Wrestling, guys, every Sunday on YouTube. And I know you can dig that, sucker.
Look, Booker T giving the slight edge there to Mark Riley, and that's understandable. I mean, right now, Riley is the favorite. He is the former champion. He has the experience over Clark Wolf. He's been playing pretty hot the last couple of times out there, but Clark Wolf also having a very strong showing against JTE.
Christian, I'm ready.
I'm ready to go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Movie Trivia Schmodown. Introducing first, representing the Wolves of Steel with a record of 4 wins, 2 defeats. She is the 2016 Movie Trivia Schmodown Rookie of the Year, Classy Clark Wolf.
Whoa, what's that? Oh, look at that.
Look at that. Look at how classy she looks. And she's walking up, taking a seat there as her partner walks her out there.
She looks focused. She looks happy to be here. She looks determined as well.
And her opponent, representing the Wolves of Steel, with a record of 7 wins, 3 defeats. He is the 2014 Ultimate Schmodown winner and the former Movie Trivia Schmodown Champion of the World, Mark Eody Riley!
Oh, heck! Look at that!
What a dance that is doing this. That's a Travolta dance. Oh, they're having fun already, man. Look at this.
Look at that.
Oh, wait. Oh, he's taking his partner with him, and now they're dancing. And now they're dancing. They're not competing. They're not fighting. They're dancing. They're having a party. Look at that. Oh, they're having so much fun. Oh, he's taking his tie off.
Whoa, look at that.
Wait, is she doing this too? What's happening?
This is
a Vegas nightclub.
It's a Wolves of Steel show.
Look at that. That was a great entrance by the Wolves of Steel, who are not going to collide. It looks like they're going to have a classic game.
Christian, I danced along. That's the most cardio I've had since the 90s.
You look as sweaty as Bibiani did throwing candy.
That's true.
2 weeks ago.
He's still in the hospital.
All right, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Schmodown, and here are the rules for round number one. The competitors will get 8 questions, each worth 1 point apiece. 15 seconds to answer each question. They have to write the question on the board. When they are asked to reveal it, they will have to show the board and also answer it at the same time. Couple new rules here. The challenge rule. If they don't like a call that was made, they can challenge it. If it gets overturned, the challenge will stay. They can keep their challenge for another. If it doesn't, they will lose the challenge. The JTE rule, meaning they can ask to repeat the question 3 times per match. And finally, in the first round, if somebody answers 8 questions correctly, they will be given a bonus question that will be worth 2 points, very much like bowling, Ken.
I'm not good at that either.
All right, here we go. Clark Wolf, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Mark Riley, are you ready?
I am ready,
so
sir.
So let's get ready to schmowdown. Woo! Here we go. Starting with animated. Ken.
Yes, category is animated. First question in which Disney film will you find Princess Aurora?
You ever go out with anyone named Aurora?
I don't go out with many people.
Oh. I'm going to leave you alone on that one.
I have.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mark Riley.
Sleeping Beauty.
Correct for 1 point. Clark Wolf.
Sleeping Beauty.
1-1.
There you go. Look at that, Christian.
All right. Category of action adventure. What is the name of the sequel to 2009's Sherlock Holmes starring Robert Downey Jr.? What is that sequel called? How's that water? Is that water? I don't think it is.
Have you ever seen an adult man use a sippy cup?
Is there vodka in that sippy cup?
I wish.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Clark Wolf.
Sherlock Holmes, Full Throttle.
Oh, that is incorrect. Mark Riley.
I green light that.
Riley.
Sherlock Holmes, Game of Shadows.
That's correct for
That's
one
correct.
Point. Riley going up with 1 point there. All right. Category of comedy.
Comedy, question 3. Who plays Richard Hoover, the father of pageant contestant Olive in Little Miss Sunshine?
You ever see that one? What was that sound? That's like a cat in the background. You hear that? Oh, okay.
No, it's just
3,
Josh McCuga.
2-1. Clark Wolf.
Greg Kinnear.
Correct. Mark Riley.
Greg Kinnear.
Wow, Riley
two.
On fire
oh,
here.
Two.
And Clark Wolf still holding in there. 3-2. All right, next category of drama. Who plays small town detective Marge Gunderson in the 1996 film Fargo?
You know, I was 20 in 1996.
You shouldn't say that on air.
I'm fired.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Mark Riley.
Oh, I think I'm going to barf Frances McDormand.
That's correct for 1 point, Clark Wolf.
Frances McDormand,
That's
you betcha.
Look at that.
Ooh, you betcha.
You betcha.
Toe-to-toe.
All right, category for the question 5 is family. Emil Hirsch's character suits up for a high-octane adventure with mechanic Sparky and girlfriend Trixie in which film? Clark really scribbling away fast.
3.
Repeat
two.
The question, please. I'm using it.
Okay. Using it. Emil Hirsch's character suits up for a high-octane adventure with mechanic Sparky and girlfriend Trixie in which film?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pen down, Riley and Clark.
Speed Racer.
Correct for 1 point.
It.
Riley.
Ted Turner.
Incorrect. Riley misses that one. All right, so it is tie game here. The Speed Racer hurting Riley. All right, here we go. Fantasy sci-fi. Name one of the two male leads in 2015's Ex Machina. Name one of the two male leads in 2015's Ex Machina. Hmm. Like we cut the tension with a knife here right now.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Riley.
Oscar Isaac.
Correct. Correct. Clark.
Ooh, I thought you meant a character name. So I wrote Ryan, which was also a guess.
Oh, all right. Okay.
I did not understand.
That's okay. That's all right. All right.
5-4.
Here we go. Next one.
Category is horror thriller. Bridget Fonda gets creeped out by a terrorizing roommate, Jennifer Jason Leigh, in what 1992 thriller?
This sounds like a lot of things that happened to you in your past.
Absolutely. I was roommates with Jennifer Jason Leigh.
That's what I thought. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Clark Wolf.
Single white female.
Correct for 1 point. Mark
Single
Riley.
Single white female.
Look at this. What a match. What a match. 6-5. This is why they are competing for the title. Last question in the category of famous directors. Who directed the Stephen King adaptation of A Killer Automobile, Christine?
Do you know JT still doesn't own a car?
Why is that? He makes money.
I don't know.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pen down, Riley. And what do you got?
A bunch of squiggle lines.
Incorrect.
If I know my partner, he's going to be so bummed. Yep. John Carpenter.
John Carpenter, 6-6. We have a tie game here at the end of round one. Even the champion, John Rocha, is showing respect on that round.
Yeah, he's got to be wondering, this is who I'm going to face, one of these winners. He's got to be ready. He knows it.
All right, here we go. Round number two. Here's how it works. The contestants will spin the wheel. If it lands on a category they do not like, they can spin once again. Each question worth 2 points apiece, unless they go to multiple choice, then it is worth 1 point apiece, and you can steal from your opponent in this round. Mark Riley, it is a tie game. You are the favorite. Would you like to go first or second?
I'm going to go first.
Give it a good spin, please. And former champion spins it. Oh, that's a good spin.
Yeah, that's a good spin.
Land on.
Movie taglines.
What is going to happen?
He's contemplating his future.
What's he going to do?
Thinking about everything.
I'll stay.
Whoa. Wow.
Why not? Let's just do this.
Wow. Was it a good choice? I'll go. All right. Here we go. Name the movie that carried the tagline, "Vampires, not interviews." Five.
I'm going to kill myself.
Three.
Please don't.
Multiple choice.
Is it A, From Dusk Till Dawn, B, Twilight, C, 30 Days of Night, and D, Fright Night?
A.
Correct for 1 point. That's big. Hey. All right. All right. What 1999 film had the tagline, "The show has been canceled, but the adventure is just beginning"?
Galaxy Quest.
Correct for two points. That's big for Mark Riley.
Big one.
That was big. What 80s film had the tagline, "The thing that won't die in the nightmare that won't end"?
I mean, I... No.
5, 4...
Multiple choice.
Is it A, Alien, B, Friday the 13th, C, The Terminator, D, The Thing?
The Thing.
Incorrect.
Ooh. Friday the 13th.
Final answer?
Final answer.
Incorrect. Looking for The Terminator. The Terminator. And your final question in movie taglines. What stop-motion animated film had the tagline, "Escape or Die Frying"?
This one's hard.
Five.
Don't take this if
four,
you
can. Three.
Multiple choice.
Is it A, Shaun the Sheep, B, Chicken Run, C, Mary and Max, D, Wallace and Gromit, The Curse of the Were-Rabbit?
Chicken Run.
Correct for 1 point. All right, so look, he stayed alive in that round, but it looked like movie taglines might not have been the best choice.
Not a bad round, but sometimes if you're not perfect, that can come back to bite you.
All right, Clark Wolf, you are up. Big spin. Clark's looking for horror here. You know she is. Big spin.
She definitely wants that. She has other strengths, though. Some of her other strengths are on the board.
80s movies.
80s
movies.
You know, I'm a... Oof. This could go either way, but I'm going to spin again.
Spin again. All right. There we go. It's the big spin. There it is, and it's landing on romantic comedies.
Romantic comedies.
I think that's worse.
All right, here we go.
All right, Clark, you have the category of rom-coms. 4 questions, first one in. Which sorority was Elle Woods from Legally Blonde president of?
It's multiple choice.
A, Phi Lambda, B, Delta Nu, C, Kappa Kappa Delta, D, Zeta, Alpha, Zeta.
I'm going to say Kappa, Kappa, Delta.
Correct.
Delta Nu?
Correct. 1 point. Wow.
Good job.
Clark, second question. In which movie does Hugh Grant declare love for Andie MacDowell?
Four Weddings and a Funeral.
There you go.
Back into 2 points.
2 points there.
Question three, which M&Ms are Mary's favorite in The Wedding Planner?
Who the fuck cares? May I please have multiple choice?
Yeah, keeping it classy.
Still classy. A, the blue ones. B, the brown ones. C, the yellow ones. D, the orange ones.
A.
The blue one's incorrect.
Oh, yeah, that's going to be yellow?
Incorrect.
Incorrect.
All right, last question.
Brown ones. Brown ones.
Brown. That was
brown.
Final question, Clark. Who plays the older Jenna in the 2004 movie 13 Going on 30?
Jennifer Garner.
That's correct.
Oh,
two
look
points.
At that. Okay, so.
One that I know and love.
11-10 going into round number three. It is very close. Both round twos, not maybe the rounds they were looking for, but it's still pretty close. All right, so round three works like this. The competitors will have three categories to choose from between numbers 1 and 25. They will range in scale from 2 points, 3 points, and 5 points. Mark Reilly, you are in the lead. Please choose three numbers between 1 and 25.
7, 9, 14.
7, 9, 14. Clark Wolf.
4, 12, and 19.
4, 12, and 19. Clark Wolf, you are down by 1 point. You will be going first. You chose category 4 in the category of dramas. What company did Chuck Noland work for in Castaway?
UPS.
Looking for FedEx.
Shit.
FedEx was the answer there. But you now have your 3-pointer is now on the board in the category of Oscar movies. Jean Dujardin played George Valentin in which Best Picture winner?
The Artist.
Correct for three
Correct.
Points. All right, so there we go. So now it goes back to Mark Reilly, who gets his 2-pointer in order to try to tie the game here.
Absolutely. You picked, for your 2-point question, Mark, number 7. That is the category of Angelina Jolie. 2-point
well,
question
well.
Is, what is the name of the sequel to Lara Croft Tomb Raider?
Five, four, three, two.
Book of Secrets.
Cradle of Life.
Right.
Yeah,
the
that cradle.
So now Mark Reilly has a chance to go in the lead here with his 3-pointer. 3-pointer.
And Mark, you picked number 9 for your 3-point question. That's Disney. Disney. Upon which birthday does the curse of sleep kick in for Sleeping Beauty?
16.
That's correct.
All right, Mark Reilly. So now it comes down. Clark Wolf now has her 5-pointer in order to go back in the lead here. Category 19, Clark Wolf, you picked sports movies.
Yes.
Okay. All right. For your 5-pointer. In Hoosiers, Coach Norman Dale's past includes his collegiate coaching career and what regrettable incident?
I think you got this, Riley. I'm going to say his brother's death.
And your winner, ladies and gentlemen, Mark Ioni Riley. He struck a player. He struck a player. Sports movies wasn't full strength, but man, what a battle. That went down. It almost went right back to Mark Reilly. What a battle. That was everything we thought it was going to be, with Mark Reilly now going once again to face John, the outlaw Roca.
Roca is screaming in the audience. He's being asked to leave by our chihuahua, who is our security. This is a Christian. I'm feeling an emotional toll watching these two friends and allies fight it out.
It was a great fight. I mean, that first round was incredible. But look, before we get into this thing, let's hear from both Clark Wolf and Mark Reilly, who are talking to Emma Fife right now.
What is up, Movie Trivia Schmodown fans? Emma Fife here. We're mixing it up a little bit today with what could have very easily been the champion, but alas, is not, classy Clark Wolf. Clark, it was a battle well fought.
Thank you.
Yes, I don't think I've ever seen the audience so united in their love of both competitors today. How do you feel about the match?
Look, I feel so happy that Riley... Oh, hey, buddy. So good to see you. Thank you. Thanks, buddy. So, yeah, I feel good about everything that happened. And, well, no, I don't feel good about anything that happened because I lost, which I, you know, which is never fun. However, there's no better way to lose than to somebody who has held the belt for a very long time, who is your partner, who is awesome. And, you know, I'm disappointed in myself for the UPS FedEx. Little snafu, and there was something in my head that was saying something about brown M&Ms. So I'm a little bummed out about that. But aside from those two, what can you do?
You know, and props to you, Clark Wolf, because every time you get a category that you're maybe not so confident in, you manage to pull it out. You did pretty well in romantic comedies, all things considered.
Well, I mean, I like some romantic comedies, of course, like 13 Going on 30, which is a good one.
Indeed it is. Now, how do you feel about the upcoming impending Rocha versus Riley match?
Well, you know what they say, third time's a charm. And I think my partner is going to take that belt back.
I think that the entire world is rooting for him. Well, thank you so much, Clark. Again, congratulations. Still one of the strongest competitors in this league, and we look forward to seeing great things from you in the future.
Thank you.
And we are back with the victorious Mark Riley. Mark, wonderful job in the match today. How are you, feeling?
I'm feeling good. That was a hard match because I had to play Clark. But man, is she classy. I know that's her name, but she is the classiest person I've ever met. I'm so happy that it was her. She gave me her blessing. I gave her one question, she would have been here. That's how good of a competitor. But you know what? I'm here now, and I am excited. It has been about 9 months since I've got a shot at this. I wanted a shot. I wanted to get back. Rocha's always talking about he messed up Bespin, and then drove him to go get that belt. The same is happening here. I get my shot now. I can't wait.
And listen, Riley, given your very impressive record, you're 8-3 now. I think that third time might be the charm, and you might have the opportunity to get that belt back from Rocha.
I'm always breathing down his neck, aren't I?
And I'm going to tell you that...
Of course he's here.
Here he is. Oh, boy. Oh, good.
Emma, can I have this for a second?
I'm getting a little sick and tired of your attitude the last couple of weeks, Emma. I'm the champ here, all right? You don't push me out of interviews. You don't cut me off when I'm talking, and you don't say the whole world is against Rocha. Because I want to tell you something about the Outlaw Nation. There's a lot of us out there. There's a lot of us that are proud of Jim. Why don't you step aside, let me handle this interview.
Fine, yes, be my guest, Rocha.
Yeah.
Just go
out of here.
Yeah, go for it, yeah, you do it.
Yeah.
My favorite thing in the world is that you're wearing that jacket right
now.
That's
right, I want to see how it fits, Riley, wear your little Superman jacket.
How does it feel to be jinxed?
Well, it's not actually, because I'm busting out of it with my Black Adam. Listen, how many times I got to beat you, man? How many times do I have to beat you till you get it? See, what the lie they're telling you is third time's a charm. Oh, no. I've already beaten this man three times. 2015, 2017 twice, or 2016 twice. And now in 2017, I will beat him again. It just gets old, whipping you like a dead horse. Like, it just gets old, my man. How many more times can you come and face me?
Breathing down your neck, Rocha. Yeah. I can see you're scared. You're putting on your jacket here. You know what? Get the hell out of here. This is my interview, okay? You're talking to Emma Fife? Yeah. You're telling you are the classless... You are the most classless champion I've ever seen. You have no respect whatsoever. You sit there in the audience. You yell at people that aren't even... It's their first time. You know what this competition needs? It needs a freaking hero.
No.
You are
villain. That's right.
You are a piece of...
No, wait,
get
what you
out.
Say to me?
Get out. I am sick and tired of you.
No.
There is no a champion doesn't sit here and call people out.
Yes,
a champion doesn't sit there and brag and say they need all the belts. Mm-hmm. A champion will step up when needed, when called. They don't ride around on a pink felt horse claiming there's some apocalypse that need four horsemen for a movie trivia contest. Get out of here. Get out of here. This is my interview.
Listen to me.
It's my interview.
Listen.
Get out.
Listen to me.
Get out.
You're gonna hear me right now.
All right, get out.
Get out!
My God! Does anybody else?
Belt,
get the f out!
Goodbye.
Do I have to curse now? Get out, you piece of God damn it! I mean, is anybody else tired
of it?
Is anybody else tired of it? Is anybody else tired of this? I mean, I am freaking sick of this stuff. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
What
fine. Mark Riley, champion of the people, the hero we all believe in. I'm certainly rooting for you, and I think it is time for us to have a hero, and the Mark Riley comeback story is long overdue. You going for that belt?
Yeah, I'm going for that belt. You know why? Because it looks good on me. Better than that, jerkwad. What does this look like? This is going to be a belt. Right on here. I'm coming for it, Rocha, and you're freaking scared, and I can tell it. You know what? Kiss my ass.
Well, I think the sparks are certainly flying. We look forward to the inevitable schmodown between Mark Riley and John Steven Rocha. Christian and Ken, back to you.
Well, no surprise there that John Rocha and Mark Riley, but how about Mark Riley screaming at John Rocha? That was very interesting. Didn't expect that to happen at all. And then Clark Wolf. What I loved about Clark Wolf is that she was very confident with everything, the way that she played, as she should have been. And we're not going to see the end of her. And the fact, yes, we know the Wolves of Steel together. They are going to be a formidable team. They might, Mark Riley, there is a future where Mark Riley is holding both belts.
Absolutely. He could be just arms out, belts hanging all over. He is that talented, but so is Clark. She put up a great fight. Sometimes it is the luck of the draw or the numbers. This was one for the ages.
Oh, man, it was just that sports thing. Had she hit something else, you don't know. It could have went either way here. But there you go. Mark Riley going up to play John the Outlaw Rocha a week after the free-for-all. That's right, 30 competitors competing in the free-for-all. The winner gets a shot at any title that they want. That will be happening in April. You want to find out more about matches? You want to find out more about schedules and stats and all that stuff? Join the Movie Trivia Facebook page, started by you guys. Also, listen to the Schmodown Rundown. You haven't had enough of the Schmodown? Well, right afterwards, on Saturdays, it goes up. Check it out, the Schmodown Rundown. And you guys, make sure you tweet at our competitors. Let them know what you thought. Comment and like. That's the most important thing. If there's 70, 80, 90,000 of you guys watching, that's how many should be commenting and liking. For Ken Knapsack, I'm Christian Harloff. See you next time.
What's up, Movie Trivia Smowdown fans? Josh McCuga here with your fantasy update. Huge match between Clark Wolf, Mark Riley. 13 points, cut it in half for Clark Wolf. Guys, it was a hard-fought match. If you have her in your fantasy league, hold on to her. She is still competing. She always puts up points. She always looks great. She always looks like she'd go to a dinner party after the Movie Trivia Smowdown. That's how good it is. Mark Riley going for the title. He's a mastermind. He knows his stuff. He puts up points on the board. He hates John Rocha with the passion of I hate vegans. I'm just saying. You can go out there, you're making your fantasy marks, you're making your points, you're making dreams come true in the Schmodown Fantasy League. For all your fantasy updates, go to the Facebook page, go to schmozno.com, talk to Frank Janish, start a league, join a league, become a league, do it by yourself, go to a Thanksgiving dinner, start a league there. I don't know what else to tell you. I'm running out of breath. Schmodown, woo!
Hey guys, if you like this video, click the thumbs up button. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. It'll help you stay up to date with everything we've got going on here at Collider.